Praise the Lord.
Au Jumalale.
A blessed morning to everybody.
Õnnistatud hommikut igale ühele.
If you believe it, say amen.
Kui sa usud sellesse, siis ütle amen.
That is a morning of blessings.
See on õnnistuste hommik täna.
Благословение для тебя.
I didn't say good morning. Everybody says good morning, and they don't believe I have anything. That's why I said a blessed morning. So that you will receive blessings. And the one who says it loudest will receive the most blessings. A blessed morning to everybody. It was on this side, they said it to the others, so they will get more blessings. Let me just share one secret with you. But it's not a secret. But it's still a secret. But it's not a secret. But it's still a secret. And what is the secret? When words are spoken under an anointing of the Holy Spirit, you have to make the connection.
Kui sõnad on öeldud välja püha vaimu võidme, siis sa pead nagu nendega kontakteeruma või ühenduma.
You all know the story of Elisha.
Sa tead Eelia loo.
2 Kings chapter 7.
Teine kuningas 7.
Elisha spoke a word.
Elisa ütles sõna.
He said, tomorrow about this time.
Et homme sel ajal.
Shall a measure of flour be sold for a shekel?
Maksab... See, mis oli mõõt? Jah, külvid, see maksab üks seekel.
And a measure of flour for a shekel in the gate of Samaria.
Et üks mõõt, jahu mõõt maksab üks seekelit Samaria väravas.
And there was a man who said, even if God should open windows in heaven, might this thing be?
Et üks mees oli seal, kes ütles isegi kui Jumal oleks taeva väravad.
And Elisha said,
see ei saa juhtuda.
You will see it, but you will not eat of it.
Aga Eeli ütles talle, et kui Elisa näiteks.
And it happened exactly.
Et ütles talle, et kui sa saad nägema seda, aga sa ei saa ise seda süüa ja see juhtus täpselt niimoodi.
That man doubted the word that was spoken under the anointing.
Sest see mees kahtles nendes sõnades, mis sai öeldud võidmise all.
So when words are spoken under an anointing,
sest kui sõnad on öeldud võidmise all,
and you receive them,
ja sa võtad nad vastu,
God's power goes to work.
Ja siis Jumala vägi läheb ja tegutseb.
To bring those words to pass in your life.
Et need sõnad saaksid toimuma sinu elus.
So let me say it again.
Las ma ütlen veel kord.
A blessed morning to you in Jesus' name.
Õnnistatud hommikud sinule Jeesuse nimel.
No, only some people made the connection.
Ainult mõned inimesed said sellega kontakti.
So let me say it again.
Las ma ütlen veel kord.
A blessed morning to you in Jesus' name.
Õnnistatud hommikud sulle Jeesuse nimel.
That's more like it.
Nüüd on palju parem.
Let me say it again.
Las ma ütlen veel kord.
A blessed morning to you in Jesus' name.
Õnnistatud hommikud sinule Jeesuse nimel.
And so that's what you call the connection of faith.
See on see, mida nimetatakse usuga kontakteeruma, usu kaudu.
And people hear men of God speaking under the anointing all the time, but they don't make the connection.
Inimesed räägivad Jumala vaimust, Jumala võidmises, aga inimesed nagu ei saa sellega ühendatud kontakti.
So walking with the Lord is a very, very important thing of faith.
Et kõndides koos isandaga, see on väga oluline usu samm.
You know, when Jesus speaks, you just have to believe it.
Kui Jeesus ütles, sa pead lihtsalt uskuma seda.
And then the power of those words begins to work.
Ja siis nende sõnade vägi hakkab toimima sinu elus.
And the Lord will work miracles in your lives in this season.
Ja Jumal teeb sellel hooajal sinu eludes imesid.
You didn't say amen.
Sa ei olnud amen selle peale.
Let me say it again.
Las ma ütlen veel kord.
The Lord will work miracles in your lives in this season.
Jumal hakkab tegema imesid sinu elus sellel ajal.
I believe those are words coming from the Spirit of God.
Ma usun, et need sõnad tulevad pühalt vaimult.
You have just finished worshiping the Lord.
Sa just lõpetasid Jumala ülistamise.
And so his spirit will begin to move.
Nii et tema vaim hakkab nüüd liikuma.
You said prayers.
Sa rääksid palveid.
And so the Lord will begin to move.
Ja samamoodi Jumal hakkab nüüd liikuma.
And I feel that there is an anointing of the Holy Spirit in the area of miracles.
Ja ma usun, et Jumala on aeg liikuda Jumala imedes.
So let me say it again.
Las ma ütlen ühe korra veel.
The Lord will work miracles in your lives in this season in Jesus' name.
Jumal hakkab tegema imesid sinu elus sellel ajal Jeesuse nimel.
Amen.
That's more like it.
See on nüüd parem.
Let me say it again.
Las ma ütlen veel kord.
The Lord will work miracles in your lives in this season in Jesus' name.
Jumal hakkab tegema imesid sinu elus praegusel ajal Jeesuse nimel.
Amen.
I know why at times it might look as if people are being quiet.
On aegu, kus inimesed nagu on vaiksed.
Because sometimes we just say things.
Sest teine kord me lihtsalt ütleme asju.
But that's not the way I function.
Aga see ei ole nii, nagu mina toimin.
When I say words like this, I mean it.
Kui ma ütlen selliseid sõnu, siis ma mõtlen neid sõnu.
And I believe for the Holy Ghost to back it.
Ja ma usun, et püha vaim toetab neid sõnu.
There are times the Spirit of God brings words into our spirit.
Püha vaim toob sõnu meie vaimu.
I remember I was in one place.
Ma mäletan, et ma olin ühes kohas.
And just as I took the microphone,
ja kui ma olin võtmas mikrofoni,
I just said to the people,
ma olin ütlemas inimestele,
I said, God will arise.
Ma ütlen, et Jumal tõuseb üles.
And I heard in my spirit the word surprise.
Ja ma kuulsin oma vaimus sõna üllatus.
And that was the Holy Ghost saying,
ja see oli püha vaim ütlemas mulle,
he was going to arise and surprise.
Et püha vaim saab ütleb, et ta saab tõusma üles ja üllatama.
And the same thing will happen for you in this season.
Ja sama on, just sama asi juhtub ka sinul
just
nüüd.
Lift those hands to the Lord right now.
Tõsta oma käed üles.
God will arise and surprise you.
Jumal tuleb sinu elus üles tõusma ja üllatama sind.
In this season.
Nüüd praegusel ajal.
How does God arise and surprise?
Kuidas Jumal tõuseb ja üllatab sind?
Through the working of the miraculous.
Läbi imetegude.
Let me say it again.
Las ma ütlen veel.
The Lord will arise.
Isand tõuseb üles.
And surprise.
Ja üllatab.
In your behalf.
Sinu heaks.
You didn't say amen.
Sa ei olnud amen.
Let me say it again.
Las ma ütlen veel kord.
The Lord will arise.
Isand tõuseb üles.
And surprise.
Ja üllatab.
In your behalf.
Sinu heaks.
You didn't convince the Lord about it.
Sa ei olnud nagu veendunud selles.
Let me say it again.
Sa ei veendunud selles.
The Lord will arise and surprise.
Isand tõuseb üles ja üllatab sind.
In your behalf.
Sinu heaks.
That's more like it.
See on palju parem.
And when you make the connection, then the Holy Ghost begins to work.
Ja kui sa teed selle ühenduse kontakti Jumalaga, siis püha vaim hakkab toimima sinu elus.
That's one of the ways he works.
See on see viis, kuidas ta töötab.
He puts words in the mouth of his ministers.
Ta paneb sõnu oma teenijate suhu.
The words do not come from those ministers.
Need sõnad, mis ei ole nendel teenijatel.
It comes from the Holy Ghost on the inside of them.
Vaid tuleb pühalt vaimult, kes on nende sees.
Their job is to speak it out.
Ja nende ülesanne on need sõnad välja öelda.
Your job is to receive it and believe it.
Teie ülesanne on need vastu võtta ja uskuda sellesse.
When you receive it and believe it,
kui sa võtad selle vastu ja usud sellesse,
supernatural things happen.
Siis imed, üleloomulikud asjad sünnivad.
God's people have to get used to the supernatural.
Ja Jumala rahvas peab hakkama harjuma üleloomulike asjadega.
Walking with Christ is a supernatural thing.
Kõndida koos Kristusega on üleloomulik asi.
Jesus has never stopped being supernatural.
Jeesus üle kunagi lõpetanud olema üleloomulik.
He is still supernatural.
Ta on siiamaani üleloomulik.
And when his spirit is present,
ja kui tema vaim on kohal,
supernatural things will happen.
Siis üleloomulikud asjad juhtuvad.
But you have to make the connection with your faith.
Aga sa pead oma usu kaudu saama selle kontakti temaga.
You have to believe and receive those words that are spoken.
Sa pead uskuma ja võtma vastu neid sõnu, mida on öeldud.
You know, it was sad that the man that said to Elijah, if the Lord should make windows in heaven,
oli kurb, kui see mees ütles Eliisale, et kui see Jumala isegi avaks taeva väravad.
Because that was his destruction.
See oli tema allakäik.
Because when the people were rushing to get the food,
sest kui inimesed jooksid, et seda toitu saada,
the king asked that man to stay at the gate.
Siis kuningas käskis sel mehel olla väravas.
And he was killed at the gate.
Ja seal väravas tallati ta surnuks.
It was his mouth that killed him.
See sõna, mis ta ütles, see
tappis
ta.
Because when the prophet spoke,
sest kui prophet ütles välja,
he didn't believe it.
Ja ta ei uskunud seda.
And then in 2 Kings and chapter 4,
ja teise kuningate raamatus 4. Peatükis,
a widow lady went to Elisha.
Üks lesk naine läks Elisa juurde.
She was in debt.
Ja ta oli võlas.
But Elisha spoke by the Spirit.
Aga Elisa rääkis talle vaimus.
That woman received it and believed it.
Ja see naine võttis selle vastu ja uskus seda. Ja ta sai oma ime.
Then in 1 Kings and chapter 17,
ja esimese kuningate raamatu 17,
Elijah
Elia
was sent to a widow.
Oli läkitatud ühe lese juurde.
Zarempa.
Sarempa juurde.
And when that woman believed what he said,
ja kui see naine uskus happened. Seda, mida Eelia tal ütles, siis ime juhtus.
And the supernatural went into operation.
Ja imed hakkas, ja üleloomulik asi hakkas juhtuma.
Now let me say this.
Las ma ütlen teile seda.
Again, it's not a secret.
Jälle see ei ole üks saladus.
But it is a secret.
Aga tegelikult see on üks saladus.
But it's also not a secret.
Aga tegelikult see ei ole saladus.
And what is the secret?
Ja mis on see saladus?
The supernatural is the strength of the body of Christ.
Et üleloomulikus on kogudus, see on Jeesuse ihu tugevus.
If the body of Christ forsakes the supernatural, they are finished.
Kui Kristuse ihu jätab kõrvale üleloomulikuse, siis sellega ihuga on lõpp.
You know, many times we talk about Jesus.
Palju me räägime väga palju Jeesusest.
As if he was an ordinary person.
Nagu ta oleks üks tavaline inimene.
He was a man that moved in the supernatural.
Ta oli inimene, kes liikus üleloomulikus.
From beginning to end of his life.
Oma elu algusest kuni lõpuni välja.
And if he were here physically in our midst.
Ja kui ta oleks füüsiliselt siin meie keskel.
He would still move in the supernatural.
Siis ta siia maani liiguks üleloomulikus.
That is the strength of the body of Christ.
See on koguduse tugevus, Jeesuse elu tugevus.
We have the supernatural.
Et meil on see üleloomulikus.
The difference between religion and revelation.
Vahe religiooni ja ilmutuse vahel.
Is that religion talks about the supernatural but they don't have it.
Religioon räägib üleloomulikusest, aga neil ei ole seda.
But those who move in revelation.
Aga nendel, kellel on ilmutus sellest.
They not only talk about the supernatural.
Need ainult ei räägi üleloomulikust.
But they have the supernatural in manifestation.
Aga neil on ka üleloomulik, mis manifesteerub, toimib nende elus.
You know, for those who are in ministry here.
Need, kes teenivad siin.
Without the supernatural.
Ilma üleloomulikuta.
Your ministry can't make it.
Su teenistus ei löö läbi.
Because we live in a world
sest me elame maailmas,
of highly educated people.
Kus on väga haritud inimesed.
Words alone will not convince them.
Ja ainult sõnad neid ei veenda.
Until they see the supernatural.
Kuni nad näevad, et asi on üleloomulik.
And the supernatural is available to every minister.
Ja üleloomulikus on nagu saadaval igale teenijale.
Some people have rejected it.
Mõned on hüljanud selle.
And those kind of ministries will dry up.
Ja need teenistused kuivavad ära.
If you go to some churches, maybe I went to a church in Ireland one time.
Kui sa oled mõnes kirikus, näiteks ma läksin Iirimaal ühte kirikusse.
You know how they build their churches.
Sa tead, kuidas nad ehitavad oma kogudusi.
Medieval cathedrals.
Suured katedraalid.
With medieval architecture.
Ja seal on meid keskaegsed arhitektuurid.
But many of these buildings
aga paljud need hooned
are being used for something else now.
On nüüd kasutus hoopis mingil muul eesmärgil.
Museums, libraries,
muuseumid, raamatukogud,
discotheques, and different things.
Ja mõelu erinevaid asju.
Buildings that formerly housed churches.
Need, mis olid varem koguduse majad.
Why did those churches close down?
Miks need kogudused pandi kinni?
Because they could not make it without the supernatural.
Sest nad ei saanud hakkama ilma üleloomulikuta.
You can't go far in ministry without the supernatural, not in this day and age.
Sa ei saa hakkama oma teenistuses ilma üleloomulikuta täna päeval.
Satan is also raising his own people too.
Saatan samamoodi tõstab oma inimesi.
And they are also coming with Satan's power.
Ja nad tulevad ka saatana väes.
The Antichrist will work miracles.
Antikristus näitab imesid.
Who is giving him that power?
Kes annab neile seda väge? Saatan.
So if the body of Christ does not embrace the supernatural.
Nii et kui kogudus ja Jeesuse ihu ei võta vastu üleloomulikust.
How will they convert those who are engrossed in Satan's power?
Kuidas nad saavad seisa vastu nendele, kes on saatana väes?
One of the commissions of the apostle Paul.
Üks apostel Pauluse ülesanne oli.
Was to turn people away from darkness to light.
Oli pöörata inimese ära pimedusest valgusesse.
And from Satan's power to God's power.
Saatana väest Jumala väkke.
So there were people who were moving in Satan's power in the apostle Paul's day.
Et apostel Pauluse päeval need inimesed, kes toimisid saatana väes.
If he didn't have the power of God in operation, how will he convert them?
Kui tal ei oleks toimivat Jumala väge, kuidas ta oleks saanud neid pöörata ära sealt?
There was one man that apostle Peter met.
Seal oli üks mees, kelle apostel Peetrus kohtas.
In Acts chapter 8.
Apostelite raamatus 8.
In Samaria.
Samaarias.
A man that had bewitched the village with sorcery.
Kes oli nagu nõidunud ära küla nõidusega.
And people said that was the power of God.
Ja inimesed ütlesid, see oli Jumala vägi.
Until Peter and Philip, Peter and John came there with the Holy Ghost.
Kuni Peetrus ja Johannes tulid sinna püha vaimu väes.
Then when Simon saw the power of the Holy Ghost in operation.
Ja kui see Simon nägi püha vaimu väge toimivat.
He asked Peter, said, give me this power.
Siis ta küsis Peetruselt, kuule, anna mulle ka seda väge.
That on whosoever I touch,
et ükskõik, keda ma puutun,
they may receive the Holy Ghost.
Et nad võiksid saada püha vaimu.
And he offered Peter Nigerian money.
Ja siis ta pakkus neile Nigeeria money, raha.
And Peter said, your money perish with you.
Aga Peetrus ütles, et su raha kaob koos sinuga.
Said, because you can't buy the gift of God with money.
Sest ei saa osta raha Jumal, rahaga Jumal andi.
Do you want me to say he offered him Estonian money?
Sa tahad öelda, et nad pakkusid neile, pakuks neile Eesti raha või?
I felt it was better to say he offered him Nigeria money.
Parem oli minu vast öelda, kui sa pakud neile Nigeeria, pakkus Nigeeria raha.
If I say Estonian money, so people will be offended. Say, why did he say Estonian money?
Kui ma oleks öelda Eesti raha, siis inimesed võibolla solvusid.
So I said Nigerian money.
Ma ütlesin Nigeeria raha.
But you cannot buy the gift of God with money.
Aga sa ei saa osta Jumala
But
andi rahaga.
On a more serious note,
aga kõige see tõsisem Simon, märge oli selles, et
Simon was operating Satan's power.
Et Simon toimis saatana väes.
And the people believed him, they followed him.
Ja inimesed uskusid teda ja järgisid talle.
They saw the power of God come in operation.
Kuni nad nägid Jumala väge toimivad.
So you know, you can't win people over.
Sa ei saa võita inimesi.
Who are cleaving to Satan.
Et nad jätaksid saatana.
Unless you demonstrate God's power.
Kui sa ei näita neile Jumala väge.
And the body of Christ will be far more successful when they embrace the supernatural.
Jumala kogudus ja Jeesuse ihu saab olema palju edukam, kui ta embab või võtab vastu selle Jumala väe.
So your ministry must have a supernatural touch.
Nii et su teenistus, see peab saama siukse üleloomuliku puudutuse.
Words alone will not make your ministry go as far as it should go.
Sinu sõnad ainult ei vii sinu teenistus nii kaugele, kuhu see peaks minema.
Even Jesus had to have a supernatural touch on his ministry.
Isegi Jeesusel oli vaja üleloomulikku puudutust oma tema teenistuse peal.
And he says people followed Jesus when they saw the power of God in demonstration.
Ja on öeldud, et inimesed järgisid Jeesust, kui nad nägid, et Jumala vägi töötab Jeesuse juures.
And you have that in John chapter 2 verse 23 says when they saw the miracles that
Johannes
he did.
Johannes 2:23, kui nad nägid imesid, siis nad järgisid teda.
Let's just look at it.
Vaatame korraks seda.
And you know when we get to the microphone like this.
Sa tead, kui me satume mikrofoni juurde nagu praegu.
We always come with our notes.
Meil on alati märkmed kaasas.
But sometimes the Holy Ghost takes us on another direct in another direction.
Aga teinekord püha vaim võtab ära ja viib hoopis mujale võrreldes nendele märkmetele, mis meil on.
And it's usually for the benefit of the people.
Ja see on selleks, et inimesed saaksid õpetatud.
Because he knows what you have been praying to him.
Sest ta teab, mida te olete tema poole palvetanud.
And this may be the answer to people that are present here who have been believing God to touch their ministries, increase their ministries, grow their ministries, expand their ministries.
See võib olla vastus nendele inimestele, kes on otsinud vastuseid oma teenistuse töö ja Jumalaga koos käimise peale.
You have to have the supernatural.
Sul peab olema üleloomulik.
Now in times past,
möödunud aegadel,
religion was enough.
Religioonist oli piisav.
Many people went to church.
Inimesed käisid kirikutes.
But we see people leaving the religious church.
Aga me näeme, kuidas inimesed on jätmas maha religioosseid kirikuid.
Why?
Miks?
Because the religious church talks about Christ, but it does not give the people answers.
Sest religioonne kirik räägib Kristusest, aga ta ei anna inimestele enam vastuseid.
People want answers to their needs.
Inimesed vajavad vastuseid nende vajadustele.
They don't just want you to talk about Christ, talk about God without meeting their needs.
Nad ei taha, et sa lihtsalt räägid neile Kristusest ilma, et sa suudaksid täita nende vajadust.
So when they see their needs are not being met,
kui nad näevad, et nende vajadused ei saa täidetud,
then they look for a church,
siis nad otsivad kiriku,
where God is moving.
Kus Jumal liigub.
And meeting the needs of people.
Ja täidab inimeste vajadusi.
So that is why these religious churches are empty.
Sellepärast on need religioosed kirikud tühjad.
Because religion cannot satisfy people that are living in this day.
Sest religioon ei täida enam nende inimeste vajadusi, kes tänapäeval elavad.
So Jesus did not conduct his ministry that way.
Nii et Jeesus ei juhtinud oma teenistust sellisel viisil.
The Lord Jesus Christ knew the word of God more than all of us.
Jeesus Kristus teadis Jumala sõna rohkem kui kõik me kokku.
So he knew he could have preached better than all of us.
Ta teadis, et ta võis jutustada paremini kui kõik meie.
Taught better than all of us.
Rääkida paremini kui kõik meie.
He knew how to relate to people more than all of us.
Ta teadis, kuidas inimestega suhelda
rohkem paremini kui meie. He showed the love of God more than all of us.
Ja näidata Jumala armastust kõigile neile.
He was friendly more than all of us.
Ta oli sõbralikum kui kõik meie.
But for him to be successful,
Aga selleks, et tema võiks olla edukas,
he had to have the Holy Ghost.
Tal oli vaja, et tal oleks püha vaimu.
He had to have the supernatural in operation.
Tal pidi see üleloomulik asi toimima.
And when people saw the supernatural in operation,
ja kui inimesed nägid, et see üleloomulik toimib tema elus,
they left the Pharisees,
siis nad jätsid variseri,
they left the Sadducees,
jätsid saduseri,
and they followed him.
Ja nad järgisid teda.
And the Pharisees and the Sadducees were worried.
Ja fariserid ja saduserid hakkasid muretsema.
So if we don't stop this man,
et kui me ei peata teda,
our synagogues will be empty.
Siis meie sünagogid saavad tühjaks varsti.
Because he is drawing people after him.
Sest ta kisub endaga kaasa kõiki inimesi.
And Jesus did so many miracles.
Ja Jeesus tegi nii palju imesid.
The Pharisees didn't have miracles.
Aga fariseridel ei olnud imesid.
The Sadducees had no miracles.
Ja saduseridel ei olnud imesid.
All they had was language.
Kõik, mis neil oli, oli lihtsalt nende keel, nende sõnad.
But people are tired of language.
Aga inimesed on väsinud sõnadest.
They want to see God manifest himself.
Nad tahtsid näha, et Jumal manifesteeruks ise ene.
Remember Gideon.
Tuled, kas teate Gideoni?
When the angel came to Gideon,
kui ingel tuli Gideoni juurde,
Gideon said, where are all the miracles that our fathers told us about God?
Et kus on kõik need imed, mida Jumal on rääkinud, meie isad rääkisid Jumalast.
Our fathers told us about the miracles God did. Where are those miracles
meie
today?
Meie isad on rääkinud meile nendest imedest, mida Jumal on teinud, aga kus on nad täna?
He wasn't happy about it.
Ja ta ei olnud rõõmus selle üle.
And then the angel told him some things.
Ja siis ingel rääkis talle mõned asjad.
And so it's the same question many people are asking.
Ja samad küsimused on, mida inimesed küsivad täna päeval.
Where is the God that dried up the Red Sea?
Kus on see Jumal, kes kuivatas ära punase
mere? Where is the God of Elijah?
Kus on Eelia Jumal?
Where is the God of Elisha?
Kus on Eeliisa Jumal?
Where is the God of the Apostle Paul?
Kus on Apostel Pauli
Where
Jumal?
Where is the God of the Apostle Peter?
Kus on Apostel Peetruse
Where
Jumal?
Where is his power?
Kus on tema vägi?
Those are the questions people are asking.
Need on need küsimused, mida inimesed küsivad.
So if you as a minister don't have the supernatural,
ja kui sina, kui sa teenija oled ja sul ei ole seda üleloomulikku väge,
you are not smarter than Jesus.
Siis sa ei ole targem kui Jeesus.
No matter how much charisma you have,
kui palju kui karismaatiline sa ka pole.
He cannot be more effective than Jesus himself.
Sa ei saa olla efektiivsem kui Jeesus ise.
He had to have the supernatural.
Temal oli vaja seda üleloomulikku.
You have to have the supernatural.
Ja samamoodi on ka sinul seda vaja.
You have to be open to it.
Sa pead olema avatud sellele.
If you are not,
kui sa pole,
you will struggle to carry your ministry forward.
Siis sa raskustes viid oma teenistust edasi.
And I say the truth in love.
Ja ma räägin seda tõde armastuses.
I don't need to play Nigerian diplomacy with intelligent people.
Ma ei pea mängima Nigeeria diplomaatiat tarkade inimestega.
So I have to tell you the truth in love.
Ma räägin teile seda tõde armastuses.
The supernatural is the way forward.
Üleloomulik on see tee edasi.
The Lord has been trying to get the supernatural to us.
Ja isand on üritanud tuua meile seda üleloomulik.
It's just that many of the ministers,
aga paljud Jumala sulased teenijad,
they studied in institutions,
nad on käinud koolides ja õppinud,
where the professors in those institutions,
kus professorid nendes koolides,
they explained away the supernatural.
Nad seletavad seda üleloomulikku.
They acknowledge that Jesus did the supernatural.
Nad tunnistavad seda, et Jeesus tegi neid üleloomulikke asju.
But they say, well, those things don't happen today.
Aga nad ütlevad, et need asjad tänapäeval enam ei toimi.
Then they give various reasons why it does not happen today.
Ja siis nad annavad mitmeid põhjuseid, miks enam tänapäeval ei toimi.
And people went along with that.
Ja inimesed jäävad sellega nõusse.
And so the Holy Ghost couldn't do much because they were not open to what he wanted to do.
Ja püha vaim ei saa palju teha, sest inimesed ei ole enam avatud nendele asjadele, mida ta tahab teha.
But you have to be open to what the Holy Ghost wants to do.
Aga sa pead olema avatud sellele, mida püha vaim tahab teha.
Like Jesus was open, like the Apostle Paul was open.
Nagu Jeesus oli avatud, Paulus oli avatud.
Remember the Apostle Paul first of all persecuted the body of Christ.
Apostel Paulus oli tegelikult taga kiusas taga Jeesuse Kristuse ihu.
Because what he had been taught by Gamaliel,
sest see, mis talle räägiti Gamalia poolt,
did not agree with what he saw the apostles doing.
Ta ei olnud sellega nõus, mida ta nägi, et apostel tegi.
And he was exceedingly mad against the body of Christ.
Ja ta oli väga vihane Jeesuse Kristuse ihu vastu.
He got authority from the authorities.
Ja ta sai valitsuselt meelevalla.
To go and imprison all those that were talking about Jesus and
minna välja ja panna vangi kõiki neid, kes rääkisid Jeesusest.
And he went outside Jerusalem even to Damascus.
Ja ta läks välja Jerusalemast kuni Damaskuseni välja.
Damascus is in Syria.
Damaskus on Süürias.
He went all that way.
Ta läks sinna nii kaugele.
Looking for believers to persecute them.
Otsides usklikke, keda saaks taga kiusata.
Because he was exceedingly mad against them.
Ta oli väga nagu vihanene vastu.
But then when the Lord met him on the road to Damascus.
Aga kui isand kohtas teda Damaskuse teel.
It was the supernatural that converted him.
See on see üleloomulik vägi, mis muutis pöörast ära.
He had not encountered the supernatural. He had not encountered the supernatural.
Ta ei võtnud ennem seda vastu üleloomulikku.
But the moment he encountered the supernatural.
Aga see hetk, kui ta nägi üleloomulikku
elus. He said, Lord, who are you?
Siis ta küsis, isand, kes sa oled?
And he said, I am Jesus that you are persecuting.
Ja Jeesus ütles, mina olen Jeesus, keda sa kiusad taga.
I will tell you what to do.
Ja ma ütlen sulle, mis sa pead tegema.
So the moment he encountered the supernatural.
Sel hetkel, kui ta võttis vastu üleloomulikku.
Lord, who are you?
Siis ta kohe küsis, isand, kes sa oled?
But without the supernatural.
Aga ilma üleloomulikuta.
Nobody could convert that man.
Keegi on suuteline pöörama seda meest.
And that is how our world is today.
Ja see samamoodi toimib ka tänapäevane maailm.
It is the supernatural that will bring many people to Christ.
See on see üleloomulik asi, mis toob paljusid inimesi Kristuse juurde.
So the Holy Ghost wants to manifest himself in your ministry through the supernatural.
Et püha vaim tahab esile tulla sinu teenistuses läbi üleloomuliku.
Like we've just finished praying for the village here.
Nagu me praegult just palvetasime selle küla.
It is the supernatural that will bring them to Christ.
See on üleloomulik, mis toob inimesi Kristuse juurde.
I was in England last year. I believe it was last year or the year before last.
Ma olin eelmine aasta või aasta hiljem veel Inglismaal.
And I saw Muslims.
Ma nägin seal muslimi.
And they were giving out Qurans. They had a table.
Seal oli laud, nad jagasid Korane.
There were Qurans on the table.
Seal olid Koranid laua peal.
CDs.
CD-plaadid.
Booklets.
Väiksed raamatukesed.
They were just giving them out free to everybody.
Ja nad jagasid tasuta kõikidele.
Once you are interested in collecting them, they give it to you.
Kui sul oli mingi huvi, siis sa läksid ja said võtta sealt.
They had a loudspeaker.
Ja seal oli suur, seal oli mikrofoni ja kõlarid.
Funnily enough.
Ja lõpuks.
They were preaching about Jesus and Muhammad together.
Nad hakkasid jutlustama Jeesusest ja Muhammedist ühel ajal.
Jesus ate halal food, Muhammad ate halal food.
Et Jeesus halal food ja Muhammad halal food.
And they were effective.
Ja see oli efektiivne.
People were coming by their table.
Inimesed tulid nende laua juurde.
I also went by their table.
Ka mina läksin nende laua juurde.
I was wearing one cap.
Aga mul oli üks müts.
I was not wearing a religious gown.
Mul ei olnud religioosset riietust.
So they thought I was interested in, you know, being one of their converts.
Ja nad mõtlesid, et ma olen nagu huvitatud nende jutust.
That was not what I was interested in.
Muidugi ma ei olnud sellest väga huvitatud.
So I was like, you know, if you want to win more people, tell them to stop the violence going on in, you know, different parts of the world.
Siis ma ütlesin, et kui tahad, et inimesed oleks huvitatud teie religioosist, siis lõpetage, et inimesed teeksid halba üle terve maailma.
I opened one of the Qurans on the table.
Ja ma avasin ühe Korani laua peal.
I saw that it was a very expensive Quran.
Ma nägin, et see oli väga kallis Koraan.
We have an amplified Bible version that looks exactly like that.
Meil on üks amplified Bibli saarnane asi ka samamoodi, näeb välja samamoodi.
Hardcover. Not paperback.
Tugevate kaantega.
So they were ready to give it to me. They gave it to me.
Ja nad olid valmis selle mulle andma ja andsid selle mulle.
Then I saw a box of Bibles.
Ja siis ma nägin ühe kastide
Korans.
Ma mõtlesin Korane, nägin ka Korane.
And these Korans were brand new.
Ja seal olid täiesti uued Koraanid,
expensive Korans.
Kallid Koraanid.
Well printed.
Hästi trükitud.
They were giving them out.
Ja nad jagasid neid välja inimestele.
Then when I left them,
ja kui ma läksin nende juurest ära,
I saw a Christian.
Siis ma nägin kristlasi.
He was holding a small tract.
Siis kristlasel oli väike traktaat.
So I went close to him.
Siis ma läksin tema juurde.
And he was preaching against prosperity.
Ja ta rääkis edukuse vastu.
Then I said, do you know that there are Muslims down the road from you?
Kas sa tead, et seal samal tänaval on muslimid natuke
eemal? Do you know what's going on down the road from you?
Kas sa tead, mis toimub seal sinust eemal?
I was trying to tell him that he can't be effective that way.
Siis ma tahtsin nagu öelda talle, et ta ei saa olla efektiivne sel viisi, nagu ta on seal.
He got upset.
Aga siis ta pahandas mu peale.
And wouldn't listen to me.
Ja ei kuulanud mind enam.
Then I left him.
Siis ma jätsin ta rahule.
And there was one Filipino woman.
Ja seal oli üks Filipini naine.
And we were talking about Jesus.
Ja me rääkisime Jeesusest.
One man passed us.
Ja üks mees läks meist mööda.
The moment he heard Jesus.
Ja sel hetkel, kui ta kuulis Jeesus.
He came back and joined us.
Ta tuli ja ühines meiega.
Then he said, you know, I think he was a nominal Christian before.
Siis ta ütles, et oli tavaline kristlane varem.
But he said, a certain Christian evangelist.
Aga ta ütles, et üks kristlasest evangelist.
With a healing ministry.
Kellel oli tervendamisteenistus.
Came to his church.
Tuli tema kogudusse.
And his son that was diagnosed with a very terminal disease.
Ja tema pojal oli väga raske haigus.
Was healed.
Ja see poeg sai terveks.
And so he came on board to Jesus.
Nii et ta tuli Jeesuse juurde.
He became a believer.
Temast sai usklik.
Because he saw the power of God.
Sest ta nägi, kuidas Jumala vägi toimib.
If he had not seen the power of God, he wouldn't come on board.
Kui ta poleks näinud, kuidas Jumala vägi toimib, ta poleks tulnud sellesse
nendesse Jeesusega kokku. When people see God manifest his power,
Kui inimesed näevad Jeesuse väe ilmumist,
they don't need any more talk.
Siis ei ole rohkem vaja sõnu.
They will say, I want to belong to Jesus.
Siis nad ütlevad, ma tahan kuuluda Jeesusele.
If your ministry is to reach people,
kui sinu teenistus on jõuda inimesteni,
have to have the supernatural.
Siis sul on vaja üleloomulikku.
That was why Jesus said the apostles should wait.
Sellepärast Jeesus ütles apostlitele, et nad peaksid ootama.
Until you receive power.
Oodake, kuni te saate selle väe.
Why did Jesus tell them to wait?
Ta ütles neile, miks ta ütles neile oodake?
They had been with him for 3 years.
Nad olid temaga juba 3 aastat.
But he said, wait.
Aga ta ütles neile, oodake.
Do not leave Jerusalem until you receive power.
Ärge lahkuge Jerusalemast enne, kui te olete saanud väe.
That means he wanted them
see tähendab, et ta tahtis, et nemad,
to go forth in the power of God.
Et nad läheksid välja Jumala väes.
And they won many people to him in those days.
Ja nad võitsid väga palju inimesi temale
Many Pharisees, Sadducees, even priests, a great company of priests.
Paljud sadduserid, fariseerid, isegi preestrid.
They became believers.
Nendest said usklikud.
Because they saw the power of God.
Sest nad nägid Jumala väge toimivat.
And so if we are going to see a major revival,
et kui me tahame näha võimast ärkamist,
we must have the power of God.
Siis meil on vaja Jumala väge.
We must have the supernatural.
Meil on vaja üleloomulikku.
We can't win people only with intellectual talks.
Me ei saa inimesi võita lihtsalt intellektuaalse targa jutuga.
Sometimes people have talks.
Teinekord inimesed räägivad.
I thank God for that.
Ja tänu Jumalale selle.
There's no power.
Aga selles ei ole väge.
And they invite people to come and drink tea.
Sa kutsud enda juurde inimesi kutsu jooma teed.
Satan will also join them to drink their coffee and tea.
Samamoodi Saatan ühineb nendega ja joob nendega teed ja kohvi.
And then he will ask them questions that they cannot answer.
Ja siis ta küsib neid küsimusi, mida nad ei oska vastata.
And then he will laugh.
Siis ta naerab.
And go away.
Ja läheb minema.
So I'm not saying people should not drink coffee and tea.
Ma ei taha öelda, et inimesed ei peaks jooma teed ja kohvi.
But don't think that coffee and tea will convert anybody.
Aga ära mõtle seda, et tee ja kohvi joomine muudab kellegi inimese elu.
No matter what kind of food you serve them, it will not convert them.
Ükskõik, mis toitus aga ei paku neile, see ei muuda nende elu.
So they will come.
Nad tulevad.
Eat your food.
Söövad sinu toitu.
Drink your tea.
Joovad su teed.
Drink your coffee.
Joovad su kohvi.
They will say thank you.
Ütlevad aitäh sulle.
They will go away.
Ja lähevad ära.
And they will not be converted to Jesus.
Ja nad ei pöördu Jeesuse poole.
Tea and coffee doesn't convert anybody.
Tee ja kohvi ei muuda kellegi elu, ei pööra kellegi elu. Muidugi me võime, peame jooma teed.
Taking coffee this morning.
Me jõime täna hommikul kohvi.
You know, and if there were tea, maybe I would drink the tea.
Kui oleks tee, ma oleks joonud teed.
But it doesn't convert anybody.
Aga see ei muuda kellegi, see ei pööra mitte kedagi.
And I'm not saying we should not serve coffee and tea.
Ma ei taha öelda, et me ei peaks pakkuma teed ja kohvi.
It will not convert anybody.
Aga see ei muuda mitte kellegi elu.
I'm not saying we should not serve nice food. We should serve
Ma ei
nice
food. Öelda, et miks me ei peaks head toitu pakkuma.
But don't think that because you serve a nice meal, you convert someone
Aga
to Christ.
Aga ära mõtle, et kui sa pakud head toitu, et see muudab kellegi, pöörab kellegi inimese elu.
They will only come for the food and go away.
Nad lihtsalt naudivad seda toitu ja lähevad ära.
But when they see the power of God,
Aga kui nad näevad Jumala väge,
then they will be converted.
Siis nad nende elu pöördub.
Then they will remain in Jesus.
Siis nad jäävad Jeesusesse.
Let's just look at these two verses, then we go on back to.
Lähme vaatame paar kirja kohta, siis lähme tagasi.
I believe the Spirit of God just gave us. Let's look at it. John 2:23.
Johannese 2:23.
Like I said.
Nagu ma ütlesin.
You know, when we come, we always come with our notes.
Siis me tuleme oma märkmetega.
But the Spirit of God may lead us in a little bit of a different direction.
Aga püha vaim võib juhtida meid hoopis teises suunas.
And we just have to flow with him.
Ja me peame lihtsalt voolama sellega kaasa.
And I believe he will visit people here with a greater anointing to move in the supernatural.
Ja ma usun, et Jumal külastab inimesi siin, et nad hakkaksid liikuma üleloomulikus väes.
Especially if you have been asking God for growth.
Eriti siis, kui sa oled küsinud Jumala käest kasvu.
You have been saying, Lord, I want my ministry to grow.
Sa oled küsinud Jumalalt, Jumal, ma tahan, et mu teenistus kasvaks.
Then the supernatural is the answer.
Siis üleloomulik on see, üleloomulikkus on see vastus.
It is not by power, it is not by your might.
Mitte sinu väest ja võimust.
It's not because you take more theological courses.
Mitte sellepärast, et sa võtad rohkem teoloogilisi õppetunde.
Now, go and take the courses.
Mine võta neid õppetunde.
But don't think that that's what will grow the church.
Aga ära mõtle, et nende tundide läbi, õppetundide läbi see kogudus kasvab.
It is by the power of the Holy Spirit.
See kasvab ainult püha vaimu väe läbi.
That churches grow.
Kogudus kasvab selle läbi.
And people are converted.
Et inimesed pöörduvad.
So you have to partner with him.
Sa pead olema partnerluses temaga.
You have to partner with him.
Sa pead olema partnerluses temaga.
You don't partner with him.
Kui sa ei ole partnerluses
temaga.
Kuidas siis kogudus kasvab?
You may reach some people but not too many people.
Sa võid jõuda mõnel inimesele, aga mitte paljudele.
Because people want to see God at work.
Sest inimesed tahavad näha, et Jumal toimib ja tegutseb.
That's what happened to T.L. Osborne.
Sama asi juhtus ka T.L. Osborne.
T.L. Osborne was a missionary.
T.L. Osborne oli missionär.
He went to India.
Ta läks Indiasse.
He wanted to win people to Christ.
Ta tahtis võita inimesi Kristusele.
But he went without power.
Aga ta läks sinna ilma väeta.
And one day he was in a crusade.
Ja üks päev ta oli seal ühes krusaadil.
And a Muslim man inside the crusade.
Ja üks muslimist mees seal krusaadi keskel.
He challenged T.L. Osborne.
Ta esitas talle väljakutse.
He said that Bible you are holding is not the word of God.
Et see piibel, mis sul käes on, see ei ole Jumala sõna.
He said the Quran I'm holding is the word of God.
Et Koraan, mis on minu käes, see on Jumala sõna.
And the people were watching two of them argue.
Ja inimesed ümberringi vaatasid, kuidas need kaks vaidlevad.
T.L. Osborne was trying to convince the man that this Bible was the word of God. The man said no. My Quran is the word of God.
Üritas nagu veenda seda meest, et tema käes olev Jumala sõna on Jumalalt. Aga see teine mees vaitis vastu, et Koraan on hoopis.
T.L. Osborne realized
siis T.L. Osborne mõistis,
that without the power of God,
et ilma Jumala väeta,
he would not be able to convince that man.
Ei ole ta võimeline seda meest veendma.
So he went back to America.
Nii ta läks tagasi Ameerikasse.
And was praying, fasting before the Lord.
Palvetas ja paastus isanda
and
ees.
And then he went to a crusade.
Siis ta läks uuesti krusaadile.
Where he saw another man.
Kus ta nägi ühte teist meest.
Moving in the power of God.
Kus ta nägi, et liigub Jumala väes.
And then the Holy Ghost said to T.L. Osborne.
Ja siis püha vaim ütles T.L. Osborne.
You can do that.
Et kas sina võid seda
you can do that.
Kas sina võid seda
what
teha?
That man is doing, you can do.
Mida see mees teeb, ka sina võid
and
seda
the Holy Ghost said,
siis püha vaim ütles,
that is what the Apostle Paul did.
See on see, mida ka Paulus
that is
tegi.
What the Apostle Peter
see on
did.
See, mida Peetrus tegi.
You can also do the
kas
same.
Sina võid seda teha?
And when he was going back to India again,
ja kui ta läks tagasi uuesti Indiasse,
he went in the power of the Holy
siis
Ghost.
Ta läks sinna Jumala püha vaimu
many väed. Signs and wonders took place.
Ja paljud imed ja tunnustähed said juhtuma
many, many people were converted.
Ja paljud inimesed tulid päästmisele.
And he learned his lesson.
Ja ta sai oma õppetunni.
If T.L. Osborne were here today,
kus on T.L. Osborne
he'd be
täna?
Telling you about that experience.
Kui ta oleks siin, siis ta räägiks sellest kogemusest.
That without the supernatural,
aga ilma üle loomulikult,
you can't really make headway.
Sa ei saa nagu omale edukat teed.
In this day and age,
sellel praegusel ajal,
people need to see the power of God.
Inimesed peavad nägema Jumala väge.
They need to see the supernatural.
Nad peavad nägema üle loomulikust.
But let's just look at John chapter 2.
Vaatame Johannese 2.
And then we go back to the subject.
Ja siis me läheme tagasi oma õppetunni juurde.
Look at the 23rd verse.
23.
It says, now when he was in Jerusalem,
aga kui ta oli Jerusalemas,
at the Passover,
paasapühal,
in the feast day,
pühadajal,
says, many believed in his name.
Uskusid paljud tema nimesse.
When they saw.
Nähes.
Notice those words.
Pane tähele need sõna. Nähes.
When they saw.
Kui nad nägid.
Then they believed.
Siis nad uskusid.
So if they didn't see, they wouldn't believe.
Kui nad poleks näinud, siis nad poleks uskunud.
What did they see?
Aga mida nad nägid?
When they saw the miracles which he did.
Kui nad nägid tema ime tegusid.
So they believed when they saw.
Nad hakkasid uskuma siis, kui nad nägid.
Jesus went about teaching the word, preaching the word.
Jeesus läks välja,
more than all of us.
Jeesus oskas kuulutada rohkem ja õpetada rohkem kui meie kõik kokku.
Let me say it again.
Las ma ütlen veel kord.
Jesus went about teaching the word.
Jeesus läks, et õpetada sõna.
Preaching the word.
Kuulutada sõna.
More than all of us.
Rohkem kui kõik meie.
He held meetings
ta tegi koosolekuid, nagu sellised koosolekuid.
That the people, you know, the people had been with him for so many hours.
Inimesed olid koos temaga juba mitmeid tunde.
That he had to serve them food.
Et ta pidi neil isegi süüa otsima.
Because the, you know, the night, the day was far gone.
Sest et päev oli juba pikalt läinud.
Maybe he spent so many hours teaching them.
Nii et tal juba oli läinud mitu tundi neid õpetada.
Then the disciples said, look, these people are hungry, let them go and eat.
Ja siis õpilased ütlesid talle, kuule, need inimesed on näljased, me peame otsima neile süüa.
Maybe they felt Jesus had taught for too long. Maybe they felt Jesus did too much teaching.
Aga võibolla nad tundsid, et Jeesus õpetas liiga kaua või liiga palju.
How can we stop him?
Kuidas võiks peatada
teda? Tell him that the people are hungry.
Ütleme talle, et kuule, inimesed on näljased.
So they said, the people are hungry by this time. You've been teaching them for many hours.
Ütlesid Jeesusele, kuule, inimesed on näljased, et sa oled nii mitu tundi õpetanud.
Send them away to go and buy food.
Las nad lähevad välja ja otsivad omale süüa.
But they played into Jesus' hands.
Aga nad mängisid ennast Jeesuse kätte.
Jesus said, you give them something to eat.
Ja Jeesus ütlesid, okei, aga andke teie nendele süüa.
But you get the point.
Aga saate sellest mõttest aru.
It wasn't just his teaching that converted the people.
Ei ole see õpetus see, mis muudab inimese elu.
Teaching with miracles.
See on õpetus koos imedega.
When Nicodemus came to Jesus.
Kui Nikodeemos tuli Jeesuse juurde.
What did he tell him?
Mis ta ütles
talle? He said no man can do these miracles that you do.
Siis ta ükski inimene ei saa teha neid imesid, mida sina teed.
You are a teacher that has come from God.
Sa oled õpetaja, kes on tulnud Jumalalt.
But nobody can do these miracles that you do.
Aga mitte keegi saa teha neid imesid,
mida sina teed. So it was not just the teaching that attracted Nicodemus, it was also the miracles.
Ei olnud see õpetus, mis pani Nikodeemose huvituma, vaid ka need imed.
You are a teacher come from God.
Et sa oled õpetaja, kes on tulnud Jumalalt.
Look at John 3:3.
Vaata Johannese 3:3.
So you are a teacher come from God.
Et sa oled õpetaja, kes on tulnud Jumalalt.
Oh, it's verse 2.
See on teine salm.
The same came to Jesus by night and said unto him, Rabbi, we know that thou art a teacher come from God. John 3:2.
Johannese 3:2. See tuli Jeesuse juurde öösel ja ütles temale, Rabi, me teame, et sa Jumalalt oled tulnud õpetajaks.
For no man can do these miracles.
Sest keegi ei või teha neid imetähti.
That thou doest.
Mida sina teed.
Notice the emphasis.
Pane tähele.
No man
mitte ükski inimene
can do these miracles.
Ei või teha neid imesid.
That you, Jesus, are doing.
Mida sina Jeesus teed.
That you, Jesus, are doing.
Mida Jeesus sina teed.
That was what attracted Nicodemus.
See oli see, mis pani Jeesus see Nicodemuse huvituma.
Nicodemus was a Pharisee.
Nicodemus oli fariser.
The Pharisees didn't want their members dealing with Jesus.
Ja variserid on need, kes ei tahtnud Jeesusega mingi pismist teha.
That's why Nicodemus came in the night. He didn't come in the day.
Tuli Nicodemus öösel, ta ei saanud tulla päeval.
Because if his colleagues saw him, they would say, this man expel him from our sect, expel him.
Tema kolleegid oleks näinud teda, siis nad oleks ta oma seast välja visanud.
So he came in the dark.
Nii et ta tuli pimedal ajal.
To the Lord Jesus Christ.
Jeesuse juurde.
He didn't come in the day.
Ta ei tulnud päeval.
You say, why am I laughing?
Ta küsib, miks ma naeran?
Because he came in the night. Why didn't he come in the day?
Ta tuli öösel, ta ei tulnud päeval.
But at least he came.
Aga ta tuli vähemalt.
John chapter 6.
Johannese 6. peatükk.
And the second verse.
Ja teine salm.
He says, and a great multitude followed him.
Ja palju rahvast järgis teda.
When this, because they saw his miracles.
Sest nad nägid tema ime tähti.
Which he did.
Mida ta tegi.
That is supernatural.
See on üleloomulik.
Now, it was so, thank God for Jesus' teaching.
Tänu Jumalale Jeesuse õpetuse eest.
And teaching is necessary.
Ja õpetus on oluline.
He did more teaching than any other thing he did.
Ta tegi õpetas kõige rohkem.
But he also did miracles as well.
Aga samal ajal ta tegi ka imesid.
And it was, when people saw the miracles, they were attracted.
Ja kui inimesed nägid neid imesid, siis see pani neid huvituma.
To come and hear the teaching.
Nad olid huvitatud, et tulla ja kuulata tema õpetust.
And so we have to balance teaching with power.
Nii et me peame tasakaalustama selle õpetuse imedega.
If you are a preacher,
ja väega. Või kui sa oled jutlustaja.
You have to balance it with the power of God.
Sa pead tasakaalustama oma õpetuse Jumala väega.
And how do you get the gifts of the Spirit to operate?
Ja kuidas sa saad Jumala ande toimima oma elus.
You have to study about it in the Bible.
Siis sa pead õppima nendest andide kohta Biiblist.
And you have to desire them to operate.
Ja sa pead igatsema, et nad toimiksid sinu teenistuses.
Because miracles come through the gifts of the Holy Ghost.
Sest imed tulevad läbi püha vaimu andide.
Mentioned in 1 Corinthians and chapter 12.
Esimese Korintuse 12.
There are 9 gifts of the Spirit.
Seal on 9 Jumala andi.
But we are told to desire them.
Aga meil on öeldud, et me igatseksime neid.
We are told to earnestly covet them.
Et me igatseksime, pürgiksime nende poole.
So if you do not desire them,
kui sa ei igatse neid oma ellu,
if you do not want them,
kui sa ei taha neid,
God will not waste his time.
Siis ta ei, Jumal ei raisku oma aega.
Not going to force them on you.
Ta ei hakka neid sundima sinu ellu.
You have to desire them.
Sa pead igatsema neid.
You have to covet them.
Sa pead otsima
neid. And when the Lord sees that,
ja kui isan näeb, et sa igatsed seda,
he will begin to manifest them in your life.
Siis need hakkavad toimima sinu elus.
But let me give you a warning.
Aga ma annan sulle ühe hoiatuse.
Let me give you a warning.
Annan ühe hoiatuse.
The Holy Ghost does not take instructions from us.
Püha vaim ei võta instruktsioone meilt.
He is the one that leads us.
See on see, tema on see, kes juhib meid.
So if you want to do things your way,
kui sa tahad teha asju omal viisil,
and the Holy Ghost says do it another way,
aga püha vaim ütleb, et tee teistmoodi,
he is not going to follow your way.
Siis ta ei lähe sinu järgi, ei lähe sinu teed mööda.
When you want the Holy Ghost to move in your church or your ministry,
tahad, et püha vaim liiguks sinu kirikus või sinu teenistuses,
you have to be flexible.
Siis sa pead olema paindlik.
I have my notes here.
Mul on minu märkmed täna
kaasas. But you see, we are going in a different direction.
Aga vaata, me hoopis räägime millestki
muust. And if I rigidly held on to my notes,
ja kui ma oleks kindlalt kinni hoidnud oma märkmetest ja rääkinud sellest,
I wouldn't have had the encounter I had in India.
Siis mul ei olnud sellist, mul ei oleks sellist kokkusaamist, mis mul oli
Indias. But because I was flexible,
aga kuna ma olin nagu paindlik,
and flowed with the Holy Ghost,
ja voolasin koos püha vaimuga,
he led me into a very powerful encounter.
Siis ta juhtis mind väga väelisesse kokkusaamisesse
when
Jumalaga.
When you draw up your service schedule,
kui sa paned kirja oma teenistuse jutluse,
be flexible,
no märkmed, siis ole väga paindlik,
be flexible,
ole paindlik,
to allow the Spirit of God to move,
et sa lubad püha vaimul ka liikuda.
The Holy Ghost will allow you to draw up your schedule.
Ja püha vaim laseb sul piire panna sinu
But
märkmed.
He wants to be free to interrupt that schedule.
Aga ta tahab olla, et sa laseksid tal segada vahele
so if you
sinu
want to
märkmetele.
Say, well, Holy Ghost, that's not what I plan to do in my service. Okay, he will leave you.
Ja aga kui sa ütled talle, et kuule, et püha vaim, et ma ei plaaninud sellest rääkida oma teenistusele, siis ta lahkub.
You have acknowledged that Jesus is Lord.
Sa oled võtnud vastu selle, et Jeesus on isand.
You cannot be Lord over Jesus.
Aga sa ei saa olla Jeesuse isand.
You cannot be Lord over the Holy Ghost.
Sa ei saa olla püha vaimu isand.
The Holy Ghost is coming as the representative of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Püha vaim esindab Jeesust Kristust.
So you have to let him be Lord over the service.
Nii et sa pead laskma tal olla isandaks teenistuse üle.
But if you want to stay Lord over your service,
aga kui sina tahad olla isand oma teenistuse üle,
he will sit down on a chair.
Siis püha vaim tuleb istub lihtsalt siin tooli peal.
You run the service.
Ütleb, et sina, korralda sina oma teenistus.
Do it your way.
Tee omal viisil.
Do it with your power.
Tee oma väes.
Do it with your wisdom.
Tee oma tarkuses.
I will sit down.
Mina lihtsalt istun siin.
I will be a guest in your service.
Ma olen külaliseks sinu teenistusel.
So he will take his seat as a guest.
Ja ta istub ja on nagu külaline ja vaatab pealt.
And when you are finished struggling,
ja kui sa oled lõpetad selle võitluse.
Then you start crying to God, Lord, what can I do? We want the church to grow.
Ja siis sa ütled isandale, oh isand, mida teha, et kogudus kasvaks.
But you say, my spirit came, but you didn't listen to him.
Aga Jumal ütleb, kuule, mu vaim tuli, aga sa ei kuulanud teda.
So he had to be a guest in your church.
Nii et ta pidi olema lihtsalt külalisena sinu koguduses.
If you will allow him to be Lord,
aga kui sa lased tal olla isandaks,
he knows what to do.
Siis ta teab täpselt, mida teha.
So are you ready to let him be Lord?
Kas sa oled valmis olla temal olla isandaks sinu teenistuses?
He said, well, Lord, I will let him be a partner, but I will not let him be Lord
ma lasen tal olla partneriks, aga mitte isandaks selle
teenistus. He said, well, we can't work with that.
Oh, me ei kuule,
you continue to run your church.
Jätka sina
do what you want.
Tee, mis sa tahad.
And when you run into problems, then you can come back.
Ja kui sul on probleeme jälle, siis tule, räägime uuesti.
So you have to let him be Lord.
Nii et sa pead laskma tal olla isandaks.
You know, he's not going to do 50-50 with you.
Ta ei tee sinuga 50-50, et pool sina, pool tema.
That's why people don't have the Holy Ghost moving in their church.
Sellepärast ei ole inimestel püha vaimu liikumist kirikutes.
Because Jesus will say, if it is your church, then it is not my church.
Kui Jeesus ütles, kui see on sinu kogudus, siis see ei ole minu kogudus.
If you are running your church,
kui sa ise ajad oma kogudus
asja, I'm not going to anoint your church.
Siis ma ei tule võidma sinu kogudus.
But if it is my church,
aga kui see on minu kogudus,
I will anoint my church.
Siis mina võian oma kogudus. Ma võian oma kogudus.
But as long as it's your church,
aga nii kaua, kui see on
you
sinu
run
kogudus,
your church,
siis tee sina
do
oma
what
kogudus.
You want in your church.
Tee, mis sina tahad oma kogudus.
I'll be there, but I'll be
ma
a guest.
Ma olen seal, aga ma olen nagu külaline.
You'll be a guest in your church.
Ma olen ta on nagu külaline su koguduses.
So, what do you want?
Aga mida sa tahad?
You answer that question.
Vasta sina sellele küsimusele.
Praise the Lord.
Au Jumalale.
That's just an appetizer I gave you.
See on väike eelroog, mis ma teile pakun täna.
Now we go to the main course.
Nüüd me läheme põhiroa juurde.
Father, we thank you.
Isa, me täname sind.
We thank you so much.
Täname sind nii väga.
For this atmosphere.
Selle atmosfääri eest.
Of love and
friendliness.
And let your grace manifest.
Ja las sinu arm tuleb esile.
We are only instruments.
Me oleme lihtsalt tööriistad.
We are open to the precious Holy Spirit.
Me oleme avatud kallile pühale vaimule.
We are sure he will bless your people.
Ja me teame, et sa õnnistad oma rahvast.
With wisdom and revelation.
Tarkuse ja ilmutusega.
That they have not seen before.
Mida nad ei ole varem näinud.
And they shall be mightily blessed.
Ja nad saad olema võimsalt õnnistatud.
So open up the reservoir.
ava oma reservuaarid.
And let it begin to flow.
Ja las see voolab nüüd.
Your wisdom, your knowledge, your understanding.
Tarkus, su arusaamine.
Everything you have for us.
Kõik, mis sul on meie jaoks valmis pandud.
We are spiritually greedy this morning.
Me oleme vaimulikult ahned täna hommikul.
Very, very greedy.
Väga, väga ahned.
So let it flow.
Las see voolab.
Let it not be held back.
Ära hoia midagi tagasi.
And we give you thanks for it.
Ja me anname tänu sulle
selle eest. Jesus name.
Jeesuse nimel.
Are you spiritually greedy?
Kas sa oled vaimulikult ahne?
I like that. Amen.
Amen.
I didn't hear people on this side.
Ma ei kuulnud inimeste siit poole pealt. Siit poole pealt kuulsin.
Are you spiritually greedy?
Kas te olete vaimulikult ahned?
Some of them are not convinced.
Mõned ei ole väga veendunud.
Well, you have to be spiritually greedy.
Sa pead olema vaimulikult ahne.
If you want the most from God.
Kui sa tahad rohkem Jumalalt.
He is the one giving it to you.
Tema on see, kes seda annab sulle.
So as long as he's giving it to you, he's happy.
Nii kaua, kui ta saab seda anda sulle, ta on rõõmus selle pärast.
Amen.
Amen.
And so yesterday we were talking about many things about the cross.
Eile me rääkisime mitmeid asju ristist.
But today we want to focus more on the cross.
Ja täna me tahaks fokuseerida rohkem ristile.
And you heard me say that Pilate knew that Jesus was not at fault.
Pilatus teadis, et Jeesusel ei ole mingit viga.
But Pilate did one very silly thing.
Aga Pilatus tegi ühe vähe rumala asja.
He kept on saying, I find no fault in this man.
Ta jätkas ja ütlemast, et ma ei leia mingit viga selles mehes.
But the chief priests,
aga preestrid,
they started raising their voice.
Nad hakkasid tõstma oma häält.
Said, if you go with this man, you are not a friend of Caesar.
Et kui sa lased selle mehe lahti, sa ei ole Caesari sõber.
Because whoever says he's a king,
kui keegi ütleb, et ta on kuningas,
he's speaking against Caesar.
Siis ta räägib Caesari vastu.
When Pilate was hearing those words,
ja kui Pilatus kuulis neid sõnu,
he was afraid.
Siis ta hakkas kartma.
But why was he afraid?
A mida ta kartis?
He had examined Jesus, found no fault in him.
Ta uuris Jeesust ja nägi, et seal ei ole midagi valesti.
But he had to let somebody go free at the Passover time.
Aga ta pidi kellegi laskma lahti selle paasa püha ajal.
Do I release Barnabas or Jesus?
Et kas ma lasen lahti Barnabase või Jeesuse?
They said release Barnabas.
Nad ütlesid, lase lahti Barnabas.
And the voice of the people prevailed.
Ja inimeste hääl tuli nagu nii võimsalt, et see võitis.
But listen very carefully.
Aga kuulake väga tähelepanelikult.
It was not the people that had the authority.
Tegelikult ei olnud inimestel seda meelevalda seal.
It was Pilate that had the authority.
Pilatusel oli see meelevald lahti lasta kedagi.
He was not accountable to the people.
Ta ei tegelikult
He was accountable to Julius Caesar who put him there.
Ta ei vastutanud nende inimeste eest, ta vastutas Caesari üle, kes pani ta selles ametisse.
But he listened to the people.
Aga ta kuulas neid inimesi.
But they didn't have the authority.
Aga tegelikult nendel inimestel ei olnud seda meelevald.
They could not crucify Jesus without his permission.
Nemad ei saanud Jeesust risti lüüa ilma et tema oleks lubanud.
They started shouting.
Aga nad hakkasid hüüdma.
They started saying things.
Hüüdma asju.
And Pilate was not steady.
Ja Pilatus ei olnud kindel endas.
He was not courageous enough to say no.
Ta ei olnud piisavalt julge, et öelda ei.
He yielded to them.
Ta alistus nende tahtele.
And he let them go and crucify Jesus.
Ja andis Jeesuse neile risti löömiseks.
My point is this.
Ja mu mõte on selles.
It may be prophetic.
See võib olla profetlik.
When the supernatural begins to operate in your church,
kui üleloomulik hakkab toimima sinu koguduses,
not everybody is going to go along with it.
Mitte kõik ei tule sellega kaasa.
Because they are not used to it.
Sest nad ei ole sellega harjunud.
That's not what they were taught.
See ei ole see, kuidas neid on õpetatud.
But you are accountable to God, not to them.
Aga sina vastutad Jumala ees, mitte nende inimeste ees.
It is not the people that called you.
Mitte inimesed ei ole sind kutsunud.
It is God that called you.
Jumal on sind kutsunud.
He is the one that you are going to account to.
Tema ees sina hiljem vastutab.
I'm not saying we should not listen to good suggestions from the people.
Ma ei taha öelda, et me ei peaks kuulama inimeste soovitusi.
It is not the people that called you.
Aga mitte inimesed ei olnud see, kes on sind kutsunud.
It is God that called you.
Jumal kutsus sind.
You are not a minister of the people, you are a minister of God.
Sa ei ole inimeste teenija, sa oled Jumala teener.
So when you know the will of God for the church,
kui sa tead Jumala tahet koguduse jaoks,
you have to follow that will.
Siis sa pead tegema seda.
You can't say because people don't like it.
Sa ei saa öelda, et inimesed nendele ei meeldi see.
And behave like Pilate.
Ja nad käituvad nagu Pilatus.
And please the people.
Ja sa ei tohi käituda nagu Pilatus ja meeldida inimestele.
Because we understand later.
Sest hiljem me saame aru.
Through history.
Läbi ajaloo.
That Pilate was removed.
Et Pilatus võeti ära selles positsioonis.
After he had crucified Jesus.
Pärast seda kui
he was removed.
Jeesus löödi risti, ta võeti ära selles positsioonis.
By the man that he was who put him there.
Läbi selle mehe, kes pani ta selles ametisse.
He was called to Rome.
Ta kutsuti tagasi Rooma.
And asked to account for what happened.
Ja talt küsiti nüüd aru, et mis sa tegid.
And he was removed.
Ja ta võeti ära tema ametist.
So it doesn't pay to please the people.
Nii et me ei pea meeldima inimestele.
At the expense of God.
Jumala arvelt.
Now, you are going to be criticized.
Sind kritiseeritakse.
Because people have not seen that operate before.
Sest inimesed ei ole varem näinud neid asju toimivat.
But you have to keep on forging ahead.
Aga sa pead lihtsalt minema edasi.
And then eventually God will vindicate you.
Ja lõpuks Jumal veenab neid.
People in your denomination may not agree with what you are doing.
Inimesed sinu denominatsioonist võib-olla ei ole nõus sellega, mis sa teed.
That was not what they were taught.
Sest see ei ole see, kuidas neid on õpetatud.
But once the Holy Ghost is moving through your life and ministry,
nii kaua kui nad näevad, et püha vaim liigub läbi sinu elu ja sinu teenistuse,
you want to please the Holy Ghost.
Siis sa pead tahtma meeldida
you want to please the Lord Jesus Christ.
Sa tahad, et Jumalale meeldida.
T.L. Osborne's denomination,
T.L. Osborne ja tema denominatsioon,
they did not support signs and wonders.
Nad ei toetanud imesid ja tunnustähti.
But one day he was praying,
aga ühel päeval ta jutust palvetas.
He saw the Lord in a vision.
Ja ta nägi ühes visioonis isandat.
The Lord looked at him.
Ja isand vaatas talle.
He looked at the Lord.
Vaatas
the Lord didn't see anything.
Vaatas Jeesu otsa, Jeesu ei olnud midagi ja ta läks lihtsalt minema.
But T.L. Osborne said that day,
ja ta ütles, et sel päeval ütles T.L.
He realized that Jesus had to be Lord.
Ta mõistis, et Jeesus peab olema isand.
Not the denomination.
Mitte denominatsioon oli isand.
If he had followed the denomination,
kui ta oleks järginud oma denominatsioonile,
he wouldn't have moved in signs and wonders.
Ta poleks saanud liikuma imedes ja tunnustähtedes.
It never would have happened.
Ja see poleks kunagi juhtunud.
Because the denomination he was part of did not agree with signs and wonders.
Sest see denominatsioon, milles oli ta osa, see ei olnud nõus imede ja tunnustähtedega.
And so when people may criticize our moving in the supernatural.
Inimesed võib-olla kritiseerivad sind, kui sa liigud üle loomulikus.
But you are not going to account to them at the end of the day.
Aga päeva lõpuks sa ei vastuta nende.
It's the Lord you are going to account to.
See on isand, kelle ees sa vastutad.
We must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ.
Me ilmume kõik Jumala kohtuistme ette.
He's going to reward what we have done for him in this life.
Ja ta tasub meile sellest, mis me oleme teinud meie elus.
Your reward is not coming from the people.
Nii et sinu tasu ei tule inimestelt, vaid see tuleb isandalt.
And then when you get before the Lord Jesus Christ,
ja kui sa tuled isanda ette,
and he says, why didn't you let my spirit move? What will
ja ta
you tell
küsib, et miks sa ei lasnud mu vaimul liikuda? Mis sa ütled
talle? You say, well, the people did not like it. The people did not agree with it.
Kas sa ütled, et oh, et inimesed ei olnud sellega nõus, see ei meeldin neile?
Then he will say, I shouldn't have gone to the cross then.
Ah, siis ta ütleks, et kuule, ta ütleb sulle, et kuule, et ma ei oleks pidanud ristile minema.
I was criticized more than you were.
Sest mind kritiseeriti seal rohkem kui sind.
Then he would ask you a question.
Siis ta küsiks sult küsimuse.
Did they spit on you?
Kas nad süritasid sulle?
You say no.
Sinu peale. Sa ütled ei.
Did they mock you?
Kas nad mõnitasid sind?
You say no.
Sa ütled ei.
Did they want to crucify you?
Kas nad tahtsid sind risti lüüa?
You say no.
Sa ütled ei.
Then he said, what was your problem?
Aga siis küsis, mis oli su probleem siis, kuule?
You know, say they spit on me.
Sest nad süritasid minu peale.
They mocked, they crucified,
mõnitasid
they did everything.
Ja lõid mind risti ja teid kõik
asjad. So you didn't suffer that.
Sa ei pidanud seda kannatama.
So he said, why then did you not let my spirit move?
Miks sa ei lasnud siis mu vaimul liikuda?
He said, I suffered all that for you.
Ma kannatasin seda kõike sinu pärast.
He said, if I looked at how they were criticizing me,
kui ma vaatasin, kuidas nad mind kritiseerivad.
I would have said, Lord, this is too much.
Siis ma ütlesin isandale, et kuule, et see
I love you, but I can't continue this way.
Ma armastan sind, aga ma ei saa niimoodi jätkata.
The criticism is too much.
Et seda on liiga palju.
But the Lord Jesus Christ went to the cross.
Aga Jeesus Kristus lihtsalt läks ristile.
Regardless of the criticism.
Vaatamata kõigele kriitikale.
And when they put him on the cross,
ja kui nad lõid ta risti,
they wrote, this is the king of the Jews.
Nad panid kirjas, tema on juutide kuningas.
And people say, he saved us, let him save himself.
Oh, et las ta päästab ennast ise.
They started mocking, saying so many things.
Mõnitama, rääkisid palju asju tema kohta.
But Jesus was not moved by that.
Aga see ei puudutanud Jeesust.
He was moved by what was written.
Teda puudutas see, mis oli kirja pandud.
At the end of the day,
ja päeva lõpuks,
the people started smiting their chest.
Inimesed hakkasid omale rinda taguma.
Because they realized that they had made a mistake.
Sest nad said aru, et nad tegid vea.
When their eyes were opened.
Kui nende silmad läksid lahti.
The centurion by the cross.
Sõjaväelased risti juures.
This was truly a righteous man.
Nad ütlesid, see oli tõesti õige mees.
But initially he took the spear and pierced his side.
Aga ikkagi ta võttis ja lükkas oda temale külge.
But later they repented.
Aga hiljem nad parandasid
meelt. So on the day of Pentecost,
et nelipühi päeval,
when Peter preached,
kui Peetrus jutlustas,
so many of them came to the Lord.
Nii paljud neist tulid isandale
because
juurde.
Their hearts were pricked.
Sest nende südamed olid
their hearts were pricked. That means pained kind of.
Nende südames oli valu, mis nad
because
tegid.
They realized that they had crucified Christ.
Sest nad mõistsid, et nad olid risti löönud Kristuse.
So it was like, what do we now do?
Ja mõtlesin, et mis me nüüd teha saame.
We shouldn't have crucified him. What do we
do? Me poleks pidanud tegema seda. Mis me nüüd peame tegema?
And he said, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ.
Ja neile öeldi, et uskuge lihtsalt isandasse.
And 3,000 people were saved.
Ja 3,000 inimest tuli päästmisele.
On the same day, 3,000 people.
Ühel päeval 3,000 inimest.
Were brought to Christ.
Tulid Kristuse juurde.
So God will vindicate you.
Jumal mõistab sind süüdi. Õigeks. Okay, yeah. Taastab siis,
and
ja.
So,
ja. Jumal taastab selle olukorra sinus.
Don't be afraid of moving in the supernatural.
Ära karda liikuda üle loomulikus.
Satan sees the supernatural as a threat to his kingdom.
Saatan näeb ohtu üle loomulikus oma kuningriigile.
That is why he will raise criticism.
Selle pärast ta tõstab üles see kriitika.
He knows he is done for.
Ta teab, et temaga on lõpp kõik.
When we move in the supernatural of God.
Kui meie hakkame liikuma Jumala üleloomulikes asjades.
That is why he will raise criticism.
Ja sellepärast ta tõstab üles kriitika.
To try and stop you.
Üritades sind peatada.
To try and discourage you.
Üritades sind maha kiskuda.
But you must not yield to Satan.
Aga sa ei pea alistuma saatana tegudele.
Love people.
Armasta inimesi.
Pray for them.
Palveta nende eest.
But don't let them stop you from moving in the supernatural.
Aga ära lase neil ennast peatada liikumast üleloomulikus.
Because that is God's plan for you.
Sest see on Jumala plaan sinu jaoks.
And let me say it again.
Ja las ma ütlen veel kord.
The supernatural is the strength of the body of Christ.
Et üleloomulikus on Jeesuse ihu tugevus.
We cannot stand up against evil without the supernatural.
Me ei saa vastu seista kurjale ilma üleloomulikus.
Look at what is going on in our world of today.
Vaata, mis toimub maailmas täna.
How do you stand up against evil without the supernatural?
Kuidas sa saad sellele kurjusele vastu seista ilma üleloomulikut?
How do you speak boldly for righteousness without the supernatural?
Kuidas sa saad julgelt rääkida õigsusest ilma üleloomulikuta?
Look at Peter.
Vaata Peetrust.
When Jesus was being taken into trial,
kui Jeesus viidi kohtusse,
he followed them.
Ta järgnes talle.
You know, but he sat with the servants of the high priest.
Aga ta istus koos ülempristrite teenijatega.
He thought nobody would know him.
Ja Peetrus arvas, et keegi ei
and
tea
he was,
teda.
He was watching what was going on with Jesus.
Ja ta vaatas, mis toimub seal Jeesusega.
Then suddenly one maid saw him.
Ja siis üks keegi nägi teda.
You are one of them. You are one of them.
Kuule, sa oled üks nendest.
Said, no, I don't know the man.
Peetrus, ei, ma ei tea, ma ei tunne teda.
There's somebody that said, no, you are one of them. You are a Galilean. Your speech is like that of a Galilean. You are one of them.
Kuule, sa oled üks nendest. Sa oled Galilean. Su kõnepruuk on selline. Sa oled üks nendest.
The man started swearing and cursing that he doesn't know Jesus.
Ja hakkas vanduma ja ütlema, et ei, ta ei tunne Jeesust.
Can you imagine?
Kujutad seda ette?
Somebody that had been following Jesus.
Keegi, kes on järginud Jeesust.
He's now swearing, he's now cursing that he doesn't know
ja
Jesus.
Nüüd vandub ja sõimab ja räägib, et ta ei tunne teda üldse.
Then somebody said, no, you are one of them.
Aga keegi,
you are one of them.
Ma tunnen sind, sa oled üks nende seast.
And then the cock crowed.
Ja siis kukk kires.
And then Jesus looked at him.
Ja siis Jeesus vaatas talle.
Told you.
Ma ju ütlesin sulle.
Now, it was not Peter's intention to deny Jesus.
See ei olnud Peetruse nagu soov või kavatsus Jeesust salata.
But he wasn't bold enough.
Ta ei olnud piisavalt julge.
He wasn't courageous enough.
Ta ei olnud piisavalt julge.
Because without the supernatural.
Sest ilma üleloomulikuta.
He won't be courageous enough.
Sa ei ole piisavalt vapper ja julge.
He didn't want to deny Jesus, but he was afraid.
Ta ei tahtnud Jeesust salata, aga ta kartis.
But when the Holy Ghost came.
Aga kui püha vaim tuli.
He spoke boldly.
Siis ta rääkis julgelt.
For the Lord Jesus Christ.
Isanda Jeesuse nimel.
So you need the supernatural.
Sa vajad seda üleloomulikku.
Without the supernatural, you cannot be a strong voice for righteousness.
Ilma üleloomulikuta sa ei saa olema julge hääl õigsuse eest.
We have to have the supernatural.
Meil on vaja seda üleloomulikku.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Au Jumala.
So like I said,
nii nagu ma ütlesin,
you know, Pilate let the people crucify Christ.
Pilatus lasi inimestel Jeesuse risti lüüa.
And then we will begin to see what that meant.
Ja siis me saame aru, mida see tähendas.
Now let's go to Isaiah and chapter 53.
Läheme Jesaja 53.
Because there it was prophesied.
Seal profeteeriti.
And I want to bring out different aspects of
what. Ja ma tahan näidata erinevaid aspekte. Sellest.
Now we begin to read from the Isaiah 53, that's where you have it.
Jesaja 53.
Now let's begin to read from verse 1.
Alustame esimesest salmist.
Who have believed our report?
Kes usub meie kuulutust?
And to whom is the arm of the Lord revealed?
Ja kellele on ilmutatud Jehova käsivars?
For he shall grow up before him as a tender plant.
Sest ta tõusis meie ees nagu võsuke.
And as a root out of the dry ground.
Otse kui juur põdusest maast.
He have no form or comeliness when we shall see him.
Ei olnud tal kuju ega ilu, kui me nägime teda.
There is no beauty that we should desire him.
Ega, aga tal ei olnud välimust, et oleksime teda ihaldanud.
Look at the third verse.
Vaata kolmandat salmi.
He is despised and rejected of men.
Ta oli põlatud ja inimestest hüljatud.
Despised and rejected.
Põlatud ja hüljatud.
All right. A man of sorrows acquainted with grief.
Valude mees, haigustega tuttav.
And we hid as it were our faces from him. We hid as it were our faces from him. Verse 3.
Valude mees, haigustega tuttav, niisugune, kelle peale silm ärgu ära pööratakse.
He was despised and we esteemed him not.
Ta oli põlatud ja me ei hoolinud temast.
Now that's talking about how people treated Jesus.
See on see, kuidas Jeesus inimesed suhtusid Jeesusesse,
käitusid tema. Despite all that.
Vaatamata kõigele sellele.
Jesus was focused.
Jeesus oli fokuseeritud.
Nothing will get him distracted.
Mitte midagi ei seganud teda.
He was focused.
Ta oli fokuseerunud.
Then we go on.
Me jätkeme.
Surely he have borne our griefs and carried our sorrows.
Tõepoolest võttis ta enese peale meie haigused ja kandis meie valusid.
Yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God and afflicted.
Meie aga pidasime teda vigaseks.
But he was wounded for our transgressions.
Ent teda haavati meie üleastumiste pärast.
He was bruised for our iniquities.
Löödi meie süütegude tõttu.
The chastisement of our peace was upon him.
Kristus oli tema peal, et Karistus oli tema peal, et meil oleks rahu. Ja tema veermete läbi on meil tervis tulnud.
All we like sheep have gone astray.
Me kõik eksisime nagu lambad.
We have turned everyone to his own way.
Iga üks meist pöördus oma teed.
And the Lord have laid on him the iniquity of us all.
Aga Jehova laskis meie kõigi süüteod tulla tema peale.
He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth.
Teda piinati ja ta alistus ega avanud oma suud.
He is brought as a lamb to the slaughter.
Nagu tal, keda viiakse tappa.
And as a sheep before her shearers is dumb, so he openeth not his mouth.
Nagu lammas, kes on niitjat ees, on vait, nõnda ei avanud ta oma suud.
He was taken from prison and from judgment.
Surve ja kohtu alt ta võeti ära.
And who shall declare his generation?
Aga tema saatus, kes mõtles selle?
For he was cut off out of the land of the living.
Sest ta lõigat ära elavate maalt.
For the transgression of my people was he stricken.
Mu rahva üleastumise pärast tabas teda surm.
And he made his grave with the wicked and with the rich in his death.
Temale anti hauda õelate juure.
Because he had done no violence, neither was any deceit in his mouth.
Kuigi ta ei olnud ülekohut teinud ega olnud pettust ta suus.
Yet it pleased the Lord to bruise him.
Aga Jehova arvas heaks teda alandada haigustega.
He had put him to grief.
Ta oma, kui ta oma hinge on annud süüoffriks.
When thou shall make his soul an offering for sin.
Saab ta näha tulevasi sugu, ta elab kaua Jehova tahe teostub tema läbi.
We will stop there.
Me peatume siin.
And we will continue after the break.
Ja me jätkame pausi pärast pausi.